By now, you've probably heard the media's shameful accusation that the NRA wants to put guns in the hands of terrorists. Here's the truth. NRA opposes a law that will prohibit people on the government's terror watch list from buying a firearm, and here's why. The NRA's job is to defend the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment's job is to guarantee the right of law-abiding Americans to defend themselves against crime, tyranny, and yes, terrorism. I know it sounds counterintuitive, but everyone on a terror watch list isn't a terrorist. As a matter of fact, some of these people aren't even potential terrorists. There's a 166-page list just to cover the guidelines for putting somebody on that list. A 2009 Justice Department audit found that 35% of the names on that list never should have been there in the first place. For goodness sakes, they put former U.S. Senator Ted Kennedy on this list. This isn't Minority Report. We don't arbitrarily strip American citizens of their rights based on crimes they haven't committed and a list they're not aware of. If someone is seriously that much of a threat, arrest them and charge them with some shit. When a person they're monitoring shows up to buy a gun and the gun store runs a background check, the authorities know about it immediately. At that point, they either tell the gun store owner to allow the sale or they block it. This is how it's supposed to work. Which is why the pathetic attempt to demonize the NRA isn't coming from the CIA, the FBI, the NSA, or any other intelligence or law enforcement group. It's coming from the most powerful anti-gun organization on the planet, the mainstream media. No one is pushing this story harder than the New York Daily News. Just a month ago, this same garbage publication called the NRA a terrorist organization and actually called for its 5 million law-abiding members to be placed on the same list. The second the constitutional freedoms of law-abiding American citizens can be denied by a secret government list they have no knowledge of or recourse against, America is no longer a free country, which is precisely what these clowns in the media want. We live in an age of abject refusal to enforce federal gun laws, disregard for immigration law, a weaponized IRS, and endless other examples of political dishonesty and corruption. So to all in the media hoping the secret government list will destroy the Second Amendment, don't be surprised when that list lays waste to the first. If you're a journalist covering the war on terror, if you might have any information about a terrorist or a potential terrorist, if you work with someone who might have any information about a terrorist or potential terrorist, get ready to be wiretapped and eavesdropped. Get ready for your emails, text messages, and private conversations to be cataloged forever on government servers. Get ready for your voice to be silenced, your stories to be censored, and your freedom to be eviscerated, all in the name of safety. Get ready for all the tyranny you asked for.